أحمد كلهم يدرون صح؟ كل الشباب تدري.
وين هاتف؟
ما يدور.
اتصل عليهم.
ما يعرفوا زين
عشان يعرف
هو انا
ضيع وقت
ورا راند ايش
نص ساعه كل مره راح تسلم
ما باثولوجي زين
لا ترى حضر معنا في الباثولوجي تو
لا في اي من
الحمد الحربي وينه
اي من
الحربي شو اسمه الشيدي
سليمان الخليفه
جمال
جمال جمال شو قال حاضر
اكيد حاضر
قبل شوي اشوفه بال
حضر انت ما حضر
صور
بصاله قبل شوي بصاله قبل شوي
longest is on the medial side, then you will find the pectineal, then ileus. So from lateral to medial, if you go for fluorofemoral triangle, iliosus, then pectineus, then comes the
rectus.
So it's
seen as
an
anterior?
Medial. Anterior, medial.
Anterior, medial.
Medial in anterior compartment of the
medial and anterior compartment.
In the medial compartment of the
but you have
to
say that, you know,
in
your
okay.
lecture.
This is pectineus. Okay, and this is iliosus. This is pectineus, iliosus, and here is the sartorius. So adductor longus, lower gap, and sartorius. This is the femoral triangle. Femoral vein, femoral artery. Femoral nerve is not included.
The
function
of this one is medial rotation now. It's a lateral rotation.
It is. Pectineus,
yeah.
Lateral rotation.
That's
right. It reflexes.
In your lecture,
and
it was medial.
There are a few mistakes in the lecture oh. just because of that Arabic version of the what in my laptop.
Oh.
One correction you have to do in the tables of adductor compartment.
Yeah.
In the tables, the adductor muscles are adductor and shown lateral rotator. Okay, Snell says it helps in lateral rotation, but all other books, Gray's Anatomy, look, this is a Gray's Anatomy, okay, which is authority in anatomy. Yes, Gray's Anatomy is the authority book in.
Why?
Okay, you can see, adductor longus adducts and medially rotates thigh. In my notes, it is from this adducts and medial. But that what I have cut paste from the Google charts, Snell shows lateral rotation. But correct is adductor are always medial.
There is a book called
Grant's Atlas. What it says? Lateral rotation.
So
is authority.
So what the answer?
So it rotates the thigh. Leave it lateral or medial rotation.
We say both.
Okay, right both. Medial and rotator. So that means thigh always rotating, not standing at one point. Should we start now? I have to go pee pee at 1 o'clock. So a leader, it also goes out to collect all the remaining persons. Okay, first of all, I want to complete three muscles which I have left in the lecture. I have uploaded the presentation, but you can see over here. These three muscles are muscles of the posterior compartment, including one part of medial compartment muscle, that is adductor magnum.
The reader.
Okay. Talk can talk. Okay, so the three muscles of the posterior compartment of thigh are semimembranosus, semitendinosus, and biceps femoris. And in addition,
adductor magnus.
Which part? Ischial part. Okay, or you can say as hamstring part. So these are the muscles of the posterior compartment. Combinedly, their action is to extend the thigh, flex the knee, and nerve supply, sciatic. Okay, so three muscles, semimembranosus, semitendinosus, and biceps femoris, and adductor magnus ischial part. These three muscles, 1, 2, 3, they are supplied by sciatic nerve, which is coming from sacral plexus. And adductor magnus part, which is involved in the hamstring portion, is supplied by ischial part, is supplied by sciatic nerve, and the adductor part is supplied by obturator nerve. Clear? Now, from where does it arise? If you look, this is the sciatic bone of the hip bone. Okay, this is sciatic. Normally, this is the position. How will you identify the hip bone, right or left?
Right.
Yes, by acetabulum. Okay. The acetabulum.
Where is?
It must be come laterally.
Okay.
And the spinosum of.
I'm not sure.
Sorry, the spine of.
Iliac crest is above.
And the spine of the
iliac crest is above.
No.
Doctor.
Acetabulum should be inward, pointing laterally. So.
So 2 points.
Yes.
Okay.
Acetabulum outward.
Acetabulum lateral side, iliac crest on the upper side.
And also
the sciatic notch. Sciatic notch is on the posterior. Put your thumb and finger over here. If your acetabulum is facing the palm, then in which hand you are holding, that is the side of it. Okay. So having upper expanded part iliac, then anterior portion body and two ramus of pubic, and posterior is ischial bone having tuberosity and a body and a small ramus. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So combinedly this is called ischiopubic ramus.
Mm-hmm.
So hamstring muscle, they all arise from ischial ramus and ischial tuberosity. Majority from ischial tuberosity. So ischial tuberosity muscle, they are coming downward. I am now talking about only two muscles, semimembranosus and tendinosus. Membranosus is half muscle. When it is going to insert, it changes into a thin membrane. Okay, but tight membrane. Just like aponeurosis of the abdominal wall muscle. And other muscle is called semitendinosus muscle. That muscle changes into a long tendon before going to insert. Can you see this muscle?
Yes.
It is semitendinosus. Arising from ischial tuberosity, running downward, turning to the medial side and inserted to the tibia. Where previous two muscles were inserted, gracilis and sartorius. If you remember, on the upper side of the medial surface of tibia. Okay, this is the medial side of the dorsal, okay, leg. This is tibia bone. And you can see the medial surface is subcutaneous. You can feel your medial surface by putting your hand on the medial side of tibia. It is throughout subcutaneous. No muscle is attached. Only at the upper part. Upper part, look, this is lower part, this is upper part. Upper part of the medial surface of the tibia, there are three muscles inserted. Okay, okay, 1, 2, 3 muscles are inserted. One is sartorius of the anterior compartment, nerve supply,
femoral.
Okay, then gracilis from the medial compartment, nerve supply, obturator. And third muscle now is semitendinosus from the posterior compartment, and the nerve supply is tibial part of sciatic, or sciatic, it's okay. Tibial part of sciatic nerve. So all three muscles are inserted where? They are inserted on the upper part of the medial surface of shaft of tibia, having three different nerve supply. The second or third muscle, which is called as biceps femoris, as the name indicates, it is having how many heads?
Two.
Okay. One head is called long head of biceps, arising from ischial tuberosity. Okay, it is running downward and laterally. When it comes in the middle of the thigh, posterior side, it is joined by short head of biceps. And that short head of biceps arises from linea aspera and lower lateral supracondylar ridge. Let me see, show. This muscle. This line, can you see this line? This is, I will tell you. This muscle is the short head of biceps. Okay, long head coming from above, combined with this, these two are going laterally and inserted to the head of fibula bone. Can you see this? Head of fibula. Lateral side, on lateral side, here. Yes.
The semimembranosus and long head of biceps, I think they all have a common
origin. Yes, I'm telling you, ischial tuberosity is the common origin. Okay, so hamstring muscle, they are taking it. So adductor magnus, having origin from the pubic ramus, extend up to ischial tuberosity. That's why the portion which is from ischial tuberosity is the adductor. It is not adductor portion, it comes in hamstring portion. Okay, let's see this picture of adductor. Here you can see. You can see the ischial tuberosity posterior aspect. It is coming downward and inserted to this adductor tubercle of the femur. Adductor tubercle, hamstring portion of it, and this is the opening in the adductor manus. Yes.
Adductor manus should be a medial muscle.
Medial muscle, yes, medial compartment muscle.
Okay. What about when you say hamstring? What's
the muscle? Hamstring means the muscles which are helping in holding or holding an object. When it is just like, have you seen the crane? Which are taking material for the building, okay, taking it from one place and going and dropping. Now there are modern trains, okay, cranes. Previously they were having only three ropes, okay, and they are holding some object and taking it to another. So while walking, if you walk in some stance of walking, our leg is in the air, okay. Holding of that position is by this hamstring muscle.
Does it the two muscles here behind?
Bicep 3. Semimembranosus, semitendinosus, biceps femoris.
But you can feel it as a tendon too.
Yes, on the medial lateral side, these are the hamstring muscles. Other definition in the books for hamstring is the muscles which are forming upper boundaries of popliteal fossa. That's why I've written hamstring muscle, posterior compartment muscle. Also form the upper boundaries of popliteal fossa. Tomorrow you have a lecture of popliteal fossa. Here you can see this is the depression of the popliteal fossa on the posterior aspect of the knee. This is knee posterior. The lateral one is formed by biceps femoris. The medial boundary upper is formed by semimembranosus and tendons. Okay, and the leg muscle, inshallah, tomorrow you will do, they will form the lower boundaries of popliteal fossa. So clear, what are the actions? As they are coming from ischial tuberosity, they are extensor of the thigh. Okay, when they are crossing the knee joint, they are flexor of the
now
of the knee or the leg at the knee joint, flexor of the leg at the knee joint. But two muscles are going on medial side, one is going on lateral. When the knee is flexed, the two muscles which are going on medial, they help in medial rotation of the leg at the knee joint. And one which is on the lateral side, biceps, it helps in the lateral rotation of flexed knee, not the extended knee. Because when the knee is extended, it becomes locked.
Yes.
For unlocking, you have to move slight degree laterally and medially of the tibia, then you will be able to perform flexion of the, and that is popliteus muscle. You will do in the leg muscle, there is a muscle called as popliteus, which is the unlocking of the knee, which the do unlocking of the knee to flex the knee. That is called popliteus muscle. So this was all about. One important structure is found by semimembranosus. Semimembranosus, when it is going to insert, it is inserted to the medial condyle of tibia. It gives a slip to the joint, knee joint posterior. Can you see this?
Yes.
This is membranosus insertion, but it is given an oblique slip going towards the medial condyle of femur. This is called oblique popliteal ligament. What it is called?
Mm-hmm.
Which is our extracapsular ligament of knee joint. Oblique popliteal ligament is formed by which of the following muscle? Semitendinosus, membranosus, adductor magnus. You will be answered will be semimembranosus. Okay, so this was all about the posterior compartment. Now coming to today's topic is femur bone. And then you will be sure.
Yes? Please, may I be
okay. So, and it's, then you will be having the lab of thigh muscle, soft tissue of the thigh. It is the longest and the strongest bone of the body.
Longest
and the strongest bone of the body, okay?
Yes.
Bone of thigh lies between or forming two joint, above hip joint with the hip bone,
knee joint.
Lower knee joint with the tibia bone. Okay, as here ulna is not taking any part in the formation of wrist joint, so here upper part of fibula is not taking any part in the formation of the knee joint. Clear? As all long bones, it has an upper end, a shaft, and a lower end. Okay?
Mm.
You can have this 3 or 4. Okay, you have. You can share both of them if he is not busy. Okay, upper end. So before going to description of the bone, side determination. How will you see it is of right side or left side?
This one is medial.
What is
yeah.
this one?
Head bone here.
Medial.
Huh?
And the
here there is no bone.
And the tocondylus posterior. So.
And the screw is the
okay. The head is always on upside
medial.
And on
medial.
And the
upward and medial. Clear?
The smooth surface is
lower end, 2 points, clear. One is head, other is at lower end, there is a notch.
Yeah.
Intercondylar notch. Always be in the lower side and posterior. Okay, suppose now, notch is posterior.
But
the head is?
Medial.
Okay, now head is medial, notch.
Like this.
So, notch is on the posterior side, head is on the medial side, so this is of, yes. Yes, this is of right side, this is also of right side.
Anything else? I was going to tell that the anterior side should be smooth.
Yes, 2 more points for your easiness. The anterior aspect of the shaft is smooth and convex anteriorly. If you see the long axis, this is more convex than this. This is concave, this is convex. Second, posteriorly there is a line. Linea aspera. Posterior there is a line called as linea aspera. Okay? This is called as posterior surface. One is a spiral line, one is posterior line having two, linea aspera having two lips. Medial, don't go into detail. Okay? In this. There is one. And in the posterior side, I'm coming one by one. Coming to the upper end. Okay?
So what's it called this?
Intercondylar notch. What it is called? Intercondylar notch. Upper end. In the upper end there is a head which is going medial. Upward. Okay? It is morely rounded, spherical, having a depression in the medial part. It is called as fovea capitis. What it is called?
Fovea
capitis. And this fovea capitis give attachment to ligament of head of femur. What is the name of the ligament? Ligament for head of femur. Easy to remember?
Yes.
Name is fovea. F-O-V-E-A. Fovea capitis. Okay? And the ligament is called?
Ligament
of head of femur. The other part of that ligament is inside the joint cavity. Okay? So it is attached to the what is this called as acetabular notch. The other part is attached to the acetabular notch. Then the second part is neck of the femur. Then second part is called
neck.
Neck is attaching head to the tochanters. Neck is attaching head. And neck is normally lying at 125 degree to the long axis of shaft. 125 degree. Okay? If you see the neck, it is at the 125 degree of the shaft. There are two parts. One is the larger bony projection, other is a small bony projection. The larger bony projection is called greater trochanter. Okay, this portion is called greater trochanter. And a small one is called lesser trochanter. Lesser trochanter is on the medial side and greater trochanter upper lateral side. Upper lateral. You can feel the greater trochanter. If you put your hand on the waist, you are at your iliac crest. Just go downward laterally and press. You can feel the greater trochanter. Yes, you can feel the greater trochanter on this side. Here. Anterior subiliac spine will be here. Okay, just go more down. Yes, the bony projection you feel, this is the greater trochanter. Okay, this is greater trochanter. Now, greater and lesser trochanter anteriorly. Anteriorly, there is a line connecting greater and lesser. Look. Anteriorly, there is a line connecting greater and lesser trochanter is called intertrochanteric line. What is called? Anteriorly. There is a line, not clear in these model bones, intertrochanteric line. Here you can see the intertrochanteric line. This one. This is the anterior aspect. You can see this line? Intertrochanteric line. Yes, the marker line. You can see the this one. Intertrochanteric line. Running from greater to the lesser trochanter. Running from greater to lesser trochanter. Posteriorly, from greater to lesser, there is an elevated area.
Yes.
You can see.
Yeah.
This is called intertrochanteric crest. You can see posteriorly, this elevated area is called intertrochanteric crest. Anteriorly, intertrochanteric line. Posteriorly, intertrochanteric crest. Anteriorly, intertrochanteric line. On the intertrochanteric crest, you will find a tubercle of bone, a small elevation in its upper part. Can you feel this position?
Yeah.
This elevation is called quadrate tubercle. What it is called?
Quadrate.
It is called quadrate tubercle. Quadratus femoris muscle of hip region.
Oh.
Insert over here. Quadrate tubercle, quadratus femoris, insert over here. On the upper medial side of greater trochanter, there is a depression. Can you see this depression?
Yes.
Okay, put your finger. This is depression. This is called intercondylar fossa. Fossa is a depression. Intercondyle notch here. Intertrochanteric. Very good. Thank you. Intertrochanteric fossa. Condylar down. Okay. This is the intercondylar fossa. This is called intertrochanteric fossa. Obturator externus is inserted in over. Obturator externus. The muscles which are attached to the greater tuberosity are gluteal muscle, obturator internus muscle, okay, and other small muscles. But mainly the gluteus medius and minimus is going to insert over here. On lesser trochanter, iliopsoas tendon. Iliacus and psoas major, muscles of the anterior compartment, they are going to insert over here. So what is the action of these two muscles? Flexion of the thigh at hip joint. And when the thigh is hip is fixed, they can flex the trunk over the thigh. Clear? So here you can see the small openings in the neck area. These are for the nutrient arteries. Okay, these are for the arterial supply to the head and neck area. Because in female, in osteoporosis, after the age of 45 and 55, between osteoporosis is common, and the neck of femur is most commonly broken when they are falling on their hip. So neck of femur fracture is common in that age.
Femoral.
On the falling down. In the neck. Maybe sometimes trochanter also goes up, okay? But mainly the neck of the femur. So, the muscles of the gluteal region and extensor muscle, they pull the lower part of the femur upside. So, leg becomes short and abducted, laterally rotated. Now, coming towards the shaft. Okay, so this is the head, neck, greater trochanter, lesser trochanter, anteriorly intertrochanteric line, posteriorly intertrochanteric crest having adductor tubercle and intertrochanteric fossa, fovea capitis. Shaft, very easy to remember, long cylindrical, thin in the middle as compared to upper and lower, thin in the middle. Okay, anteriorly it is smooth and having convex.
Convex
means going upside. This is convex and this is concave. So anteriorly it is convex and it is lying obliquely downward medially. This is not the normal anatomical position like here. This is not the anatomical. It is lying just oblique. Bone is going downward and medially oblique just to make a joint with the tibia bone. If it goes like this normal, the lateral condyle goes up. Okay, so Allah subhanahu put this bone like this, having obliquely going medially downwards towards the head of the, so the head of the tibia is going to make joint, knee joint. Okay, so in this posteriorly you will be having a prominent line which is more prominent in the middle. This line is called as
linea aspera
or posterior border, some books say linea aspera.
Yes.
What it is?
Linea aspera.
Linea aspera. On above lateral side of linea aspera you will find a rough area, and that rough area is called gluteal tuberosity for the gluteus maximus muscle. Okay? This is the gluteal tuberosity. Okay, this blue line, 112 I think written. So this is the gluteal tuberosity for gluteus maximus muscle. Gluteus maximus muscle is inserted to the gluteal tuberosity and tensor fascia later. Okay, on the iliotibial tract. Iliotibial tract, which is the thickening of the deep fascia of thigh on lateral side. On above the lateral lip of linea aspera, there is a rough area which is called gluteal tuberosity. Okay, if you go in detail, then if we want to go in detail, because you are not needed that detail. This tubercle having an apex, trochanter apex, a medial side, lateral side, posterior, so don't, just remember this is trochanter. Okay, having anterior, so main point. Clear?
Yes.
Now coming towards the linea aspera, when going downward, it divides into two lines. One is going towards the lateral side and one is going towards the medial side, posteriorly. Okay, linea aspera is on the posterior side. You can see it is dividing into two parts. One is going medially, one is going laterally.
Yes.
And they are going towards the lateral condyle and medial condyle, making a triangular area in the lower posterior surface. Can you see this?
Yes.
Making a triangular area in the lower posterior side. This is called popliteal surface. What it is called?
Popliteus
surface. And this is forming floor of the popliteal fossa. What it is? Popliteal surface. Now medial supracondylar ridge, when you trace downwards, it ends on a tubercle.
Yes.
It ends on a tubercle. Medial supracondylar ends, which is called adductor
tubercle.
Which muscle is inserted at this point?
Adductor.
Which part of it? Don't say completely.
Ischial part.
Ischial part or hamstring part. Ischial part or hamstring part of this muscle. What is the nerve supply of adductor magnus? Half obturator, half ischial. Because the muscle is adductor magnus.
Yes.
We are asking nerve supply of that muscle. Okay. So you have to give both. But clearly say ischial part of adductor magnus. Okay? That means we are talking about adductor magnus. Linea aspera, origin and insertion of the muscle. Insertion of all adductor muscles.
Yeah.
Adductor longus, brevis, magnus. Okay? Upper part pectineus. Upper part? Pectineus, okay? So we are talking about pectineus, adductor longus, brevis, and magnus. Also, origin of, if we come anterior compartment muscle, vastus medialis from linea aspera. And from lateral side, vastus lateralis. And remain all smooth surface is vastus intermedialis. You can see vastus medialis. Long original,
yes.
Vastus lateralis along and vastus intermedius. Look, this is,
yes.
Sorry, this is medius and vastus medialis, vastus lateralis and intermedius. Anterior aspect also, because they are coming from here, okay, and on the lateral side, a medial side, and from the this part and the medial side.
Okay,
and remaining all, yes, like this. And attach with the intermediate part, then go straight downward. Take the insertion of rectus femoris also to form quadriceps.
Nice.
They are inserted to the tibia bone, or sorry, patella. Quadriceps tendon first go to patella, and through patellar ligament to tibial tuberosity. So this is the whole insertion of quadriceps femoris. Nerve supply, as you know, that it is
femoral.
Clear? Now the lower end. Lower end. Lower end is having two rounded bodies. They are called as condyles.
That's
two rounded condyle. If you trace from medial side head, medial condyle. This is lateral condyle. Medial condyle and lateral condyle. Anteriorly between condyle there is a smooth surface. This is called patellar surface. What it is called? Patellar surface for the patella, which is the largest sesamoid bone present in quadriceps tendon. It is lying in the quadriceps tendon. Largest bone, sesamoid. Posteriorly, between two condyle, this is intercondylar fossa or intercondylar notch. Posteriorly, intercondylar fossa and notch. This is mostly intracapsular of the knee joint, and the intercapsule ligaments are attached on the notch area. Okay, intercondylar notch give attachment to the ligaments of the knee joint. Adductor tubercle have also a clinical importance, medico-legal importance. What? Adductor tubercle ossify just at the time of birth. First breath took by the baby, after delivery, the ossification center for lower end appears in this portion. How it is important medico-legally? Medico-legally it is important that suppose a delivery occurred in a maternity home. Doctor or nurse came out and said, sorry, your baby is dead, it is not survived. Okay, usually we take the baby home and do everything. But if you know the clinical importance of this, either the baby was dead before birth or it died due to mishandling of the doctors or nurses after birth. What you have to do, only do x-ray of that baby, of the knee joint. If you see a white dot at the adductor tubercle area, that means baby was alive at the time of birth, it died after birth. And if doctor says no, it was born death, that means something is wrong in between.
No,
so this
no
is, yes.
There's no mistake in here.
Maybe, everywhere, every part of the world, okay. But the confirmation, sometimes later on they think that there is a problem with here. So medico-legally, this x-ray is helpful, either the baby was alive or adductor tubercle. Have to? Yes, so many times. Important thing, adductor tubercle is hamstring insertion. Second important is medico-legal aspect, it ossified at the time of birth. Okay, so quick review, head, fovea, neck. Greater trochanter, lesser trochanter. Intertrochanteric line anteriorly, intertrochanteric crest posteriorly. Adduct quadrate tubercle for quadriceps femoris. Intertrochanteric fossa. Okay? Then coming to the shaft, posteriorly linea aspera. Giving insertion to pectineus, adductor longus, brevis, and magnus. Clear? Median and lateral lip. Also gave origin, medial gave vastus medialis, lateral gave vastus lateral, and all the anterior aspects was vastus intermedialis. Lesser trochanter insertion of iliosos. Lesser trochanter, iliosos. Okay, lower end having two condyles. On medial side, the linea aspera posteriorly divide into medial supracondylar ridge in the lower end and lateral supracondylar ridge. Medial condylar ridge ends at adductor tubercle, which has clinical importance as well as insertion of hamstring and intercondylar notch. And the rounded condyles, they are going to form the joints between. This is popliteal surface, the between the condyles and two lines, this is popliteal.
And the patellar surface.
Patellar surface on lower anterior.
Lower anterior.
Okay, yes, finish. Take a rest for 5 minutes. Let the doctor come. Your attendant.
Can I ask questions? Many individuals.
Voila.
Your lecture. Voila.
There are some few mistakes in the lecture, typing mistakes, which I have noted. Number one, adductor. There is an abductor magnus written over there. Make it adductor, or I'll go and make correction. Then again,
yes.
Second.
All done. Pectineus.
Pectineus considered medial muscle because it takes nerve supply from obturator. Nerve supply is obturator. But it acting as flexor of thigh only. That's why flexor of thigh are mainly from the anterior, the iliacus and soft medial muscle.
Okay, what about the adductors?
Adductors now. Adductors, they I can show you in this. I've just told you that adductors are mainly the medial rotators. But in the Snell book,
there,
they have written. But Gray's anatomy says they are medial rotators.
How is work as a medial?
Okay, how? Look, muscles are going from here. Okay, look at this. This is the normal left hip joint. Muscles are arising from this pubic bone. They are going over here. They are going to the linea aspera. They are bringing this, and also they are rotating like this.
It can't? No.
Look at this medial. Okay, how comes humerus? It is going on the left lip of the bicipital groove, pectoralis major.
Mm.
It is adductor as well as medial. It is adductor.
It's inserted to the lateral aspect of the
linea
aspera.
Yes. Okay. Now here, it is going like here. Adductor, and when it pulls the medial lip, it also for the slight medial rotation. But Snell says it is redder, but we take Gray's as this is Gray's. Gray says adductor and medially rotates thigh. Adduction and the medial rotation. Adductor and
the
pectineus is supplied by obturator. Let me check. I'm a bit confused over here. See here. Is from
which show?
Femoral nerve, yes. It is flexor and adductor. It is adductor and the flexor of the iliac nerve supply, femoral nerve, but it is muscle of medial bone. Muscle of medial compartment supplied by femoral nerve acting as a muscle of medial nerve because it is adducting and flexing the nerve. So number one. Second, this medial rotation. In notes I have written from here medial rotator, but the chart which is given it is from a Snell book. Snell says lateral rotation. But Gray's is the authority in it. The thick edition, which is the 40th or 41st edition. This is the authority of an because it was not in there is a muscle, tensor of fascia lata. Look, there is a muscle on the lateral side of the thigh, tensor of fascia lata, but it comes in the gluteal region. It arises from iliac crest, so gluteal teacher must have because tensor of fascia lata is inserted to iliotibial tract. Gluteus maximus is also inserted to the iliotibial. So the gluteal region teacher must have told you. Otherwise, it arises from the iliac crest and inserted to the iliotibial tract. What it do when it contract? It tends the fascia. That's all. Okay, attendance, attendance. Lecture adduction, femoral and obturator. So, this
obturator.
Okay, attendance. Let me write your number. Give it to me, give it to me. These are present numbers only. Give it to me. No, I don't want extra numbers.
Yeah,
what is your number? What is your number? 26. Your number? 24.
43.
Yeah.
17. 17. 35. 35. 44. 44. Last, everything. Everyone.